Renin angiotensin system or renin angiotensin aldosterone system exists in two forms in our body, that is circulating RAS and local RAS. RAS, that is renin angiotensin system. RAS is a classic example of endocrine system. It helps to regulate blood pressure and extracellular volume in the body. Considering circulatory RAS, the component of RAS are as follows. Angiotensinogen. Angiotensinogen is a plasma alpha-globulin precursor for angiotensin 2. Angiotensin 1. Angiotensin 1 is an inactive decapeptide whose biological potency is 100th time of angiotensin 2, and it is rapidly converted into angiotensin 2 in the presence of angiotensin converting enzyme. Renin is a pressor action of kidney extract, an enzyme which acts indirectly and converts angiotensinogen into angiotensin 1. The T-half for renin is 15 minutes and it is available in kidney juxtaglomerular cells. Angiotensin 2. Angiotensin 2 is an active vasopeptide, that is, it is an octapeptide whose T-half is 1 minute and which is converted into angiotensin 3 and 4, that is heptapeptide and hexapeptide, in the presence of aminopeptidases. ACE. Angiotensin converting enzyme. ACE is an ectoenzyme located on primary surface of vascular endothelial cells, especially lungs. Now, what causes the activation of RAS? So, the loss of sodium chloride, low blood pressure, low blood volume, and low glomerular filtrate, afferent pressure sensed by the body leads to activation of RAS, renin angiotensin system. The activation of RAS leads to release of renin from the kidney JG cells, juxtaglomerular cells. With the release of renin from the JG cells is the production of angiotensin 2. The angiotensin 2 is a vasoactive peptide which is released and leads to vasoconstriction, rise in blood pressure, increase in blood volume, and sodium water retention. This balances the loss of the body. With increase in the blood pressure and blood volume comes the negative feedback, so as to counterbalance the release, increase in the body of these pressures, which leads to minimize or reduce the release of renin in the body. Now, the system begins with a decrease in blood pressure and blood volume in the body. So, the angiotensinogen, जो कि लीवर में अवेलेबल है, वो यहाँ से रिलीज होता है लीवर से, और साथ में an enzyme which is present in kidney also releases with the angiotensinogen. This enzyme renin cleaves angiotensinogen and produces angiotensin 1. Up now, all the further conversion on angiotensin will be carried away by ACE, angiotensin converting enzyme that is predominantly available in the lungs. ACE, that is angiotensin converting enzyme, converts inactive angiotensin 1 into vasoactive peptide angiotensin 2 with the release of nitric oxide from smooth muscle cells. This angiotensin 2 binds with the receptor, angiotensin receptor, and induces vasoconstriction in the blood vessels. In addition to this, the stimulation of angiotensin receptor causes adrenal gland to release aldosterone hormone, which leads to sodium retention. And collectively, vasoconstriction and sodium retention leads to increase in blood pressure. The increase in blood pressure further leads the kidney to reduce the production of renin. This reduced production of renin controls the level increased blood pressure as a negative feedback. Now, there are not only one receptor of angiotensin available on the membrane. There are four of such kinds, mostly angiotensin 1, which is available on kidney, heart, vascular smooth muscle, brain, platelet, and placenta. Angiotensin 2 receptor is available on uterus, adrenal, CNS, kidney, and heart. Angiotensin 2 second receptor opposes all the functions produced by angiotensin 1 receptor. And apart from both of these, the third receptor is AT4, which stimulates the synthesis of PAI1 and decreases fibrolysis and increases cell proliferation.